Unlock the incredible potential of your iOS and macOS app development with the amazing integration of ChatGPT 4, now available for free in VS Code and Xcode. Yes, ChatGPT 4 enhances problem solving, generates code snippets, and provides valuable insights, all for free. For free. But ChatGPT 4 is available for a monthly fee, right? Yes, but in this video, I'm going to show you how you can get it for free. Don't forget to check out the link in the description for a 75% off on SwiftUI Camp. The offer ends on Christmas Day. Go ahead and check it out. It's right over there. Now, we are going to add ChatGPT 4 into our development environment. Yes, ChatGPT 4 is behind a paywall. You know, you can have a GPT 3.5 for free, but no, for 4 you have to upgrade to the Pro plan. Now, today I'm going to show you how you can use GPT 4 for free for coding. And I have also created a blog post. Go ahead again, check out the link in the description for the blog post too, where you have a written format of this video tutorial. But if you want to follow along so you can see how all of this is done, then make sure to continue watching. And also I'm going to provide all of the chapters so you can jump to the specific places. Now, we want to have ChatGPT 4 for free. Now, in Xcode, we don't have anything like that. We kind of have a GitHub for Copilot with ChatGPT 4 chat in feature, but for that you have to give your actual OpenAI API key. Go ahead, it's another video that I have. Again, I will link it in the description and also in the cards right over here. Now, we want this for free. That's the whole purpose of this. We want ChatGPT 4 for free. Now we can do that through VS Code. Yes, we are going to code in VS Code for iOS and macOS, and along the way, we are going to use ChatGPT 4 for free. Now, first of all, you have to download VS Code. You can click over here and download VS Code for free. And then what you need to do is go ahead and go to Codeium.com. And basically, you want to sign up for their chat beta version. Let me just click over here so we can see what I mean. You have to go and click on this button, Join GPT-4 Beta Waitlist. Now, if you want to skip the waitlist and get into a priority queue, then go ahead and DM me on X/Twitter and I will send you my personal link, which will put you really, really ahead in the queue. Here is the link for that. Now, once you have that, of course, you have to have that. Otherwise, you just have ChatGPT 3.5. Once you have that, just continue with the tutorial. So you want to go to the VS Code extension. So let's open that inside a new link, Codeium in Visual Studio Code. So let's click on the quick install. Let's allow that. There we go. VS Code will open up. Again, you need to install VS Code first, and then let's click on install, installing. That's right. And you will see that Codeium is right over here. Great. And you will be able to access Codeium right over here. Let me just make this a little bit wider so we can see a little bit better. There we go. And there you go. We have GPT-4 on the Pro version. Again, you need to enable this. Now, if you just select that, you can just ask anything of GPT-4, like what is Swift UI? Let me just correct that. And it will just give you the definitions. And also you can have this for coding purposes, all of that stuff. Now, this is really, really great, but there's a caveat here. You also want to work in VS Code, right? Because you can copy this code out, and you don't want to jump into Xcode for just to have this code. You want to work in VS Code, and you want to have auto completion. Now, VS Code doesn't support the Xcode debugger, all of the auto completion, but we can install it. So let's just go back to our blog post right over here, and let's see. How can we add auto-completion? This is the basic thing that we want to have at least. Because, yeah, ChatGPT completion from Codeium is already in there, but we don't have auto-completion. Now, before we get into the installation, what I'm going to do is just create a new Xcode project so we can actually open up some a project in VS Code. So let's create a new project. Let me just move it right over here. That's right. It will be an app. I know it's a long title, but basically that's it. Let's click on next over here. Drop it onto the desktop. I don't care about the Git repository. Let's create that. And now we will be able to open this up inside VS Code. This Christmas, consider gifting yourself the invaluable present of knowledge. As the year comes to an end, I'm looking forward to help you start the new one with a bang. Therefore, I'm giving an unprecedented discount to the SwiftUI Camp cohort of January. You can get in for a whopping 75% off. The offer ends on December 24th. Start the year mastering SwiftUI in only 4 weeks. If you like my Swift stuff here, think of the value you are going to get inside SwiftUI Camp. Seats are limited to 5, so join today. The link is down in the description. So let's jump into Visual Studio Code and let's open up a folder and a desktop. This one, let's open it up. Yes, I trust the author. There we go. We can now go into these files, for example, the content view, and we have it right over here. Now, Codeium already works, so if I hit a new line over here, it's just suggesting some code completions, which is really, really nice. Again, you have a chat over here, and you can just select a GPT for that. But if I just start typing over here, like, I don't know, padding, you see, we don't have auto-completion, so let's fix that. Let's have SwiftUI, Swift auto-completion inside VS Code. Let's go back to our blog post again. First of all, we need to install the official Swift extension. Again, let's open this in a new tab. Let's go back and click on install, allow that, click on the install, it's installing, great. Let's see what is our next step. Build your project in Xcode. Okay, let's, of course, you want to create this and build it up. So let's hit Command B. So it's going to build. Build succeeded. Great. Download or clone the repository for Xcode build server. Now, this is where the magic happens. You want to open this up inside a new link. And then click on code right over here. And what I will do is just download it inside a zip file and then store it somewhere safe. Create create a new folder for it. What I will do is basically drop it right over here under the work. So let me just go ahead and there we go. What we need to do is just go ahead and remove the master right over there. Next up, we want to create a link file to Xcode build server file from a downloaded directory. Okay, so this is the code. And again, I recommend that you go to the blog post and now copy it out. And what we need to do is open up terminal. So terminal, there we go. And then we want to navigate to Xcode build server. So ln minus s a space, and then the path to the build server. So we want to go and grab this folder and drag and drop it into your terminal. There we go. Now we want to add if it hasn't added a space, and then -usr-local-bin. Okay, so -usr-local-bin. There we go. Now, file already does exist for myself because I have already created it, but it will create it for yourself. Step number five, navigate to your project and run this one. So let's just go and cd into our project. Let's see, desktop, and drag and drop it again. There we go. We navigated right over there. And then copy out this code. If it's a workspace for that, then it's a workspace. Mine is a project. So what we want to do is copy out this line of code and then paste it in there. And then what you want to do is replace your project name. And I think I shot myself in the foot right over here in terms of typing because it's a long one. So what I'm going to do is basically copy it from the folder and then go back to terminal and replace that just like that. There we go. Now let's just hit a return. Now, what this did is created a buildserver.json. Mine, of course, has been updated, but for you, it's going to create it. And basically, that's it. Now, if you go back to VS Code, we should have auto-completion. So let's go to the content view. So let's test this out. Let's add the padding. And as you can see, now we have these auto-completion blocks. It's really, really nice. Now, what you have to do is just hit Command S to save the file, or if you have set it up on autosave, it will just do it automatically. And now we should be able to see all of these changes in Xcode automatically. It's really, really amazing. Now, if you did like this video, make sure to check out my sale on SwiftUI Camp. It's down in the description. And if you want to learn how to properly create prompts for ChatGPT, make sure to check out this video right over here.